When building a cloud-native app, if you're looking for a cloud database that's reliable, relational, and open source, Azure Database for PostgreSQL checks all the boxes. For the first part of today's demo, I'll show you two of the new capabilities we've introduced that make it easier than ever to get started with Postgres. It makes your applications future-proof by making scaling easy. It's powered by the open-source Citus extension, which transforms Postgres into a distributed database. With the basic tier that's now in preview, you can use Hyperscale Citus on a single node. This smaller footprint means cost savings. In fact, it's now 7x less to get started. But even better, the basic tier gives you the power to build modern apps that are scale-out ready from day one, letting you start small and later grow seamlessly to tens of Postgres nodes. It takes only a few minutes to provision a basic tier database. Once ready, I can check the Azure portal and see that it's running on the latest Postgres version, Postgres 13, and the latest Citus version, Citus 10. We also realize how important it is to do testing on your local dev machine. For that, I'll just run the single Docker run command, which we introduced with Citus 10. Within seconds, I get functional parity with the cloud, with open source Citus and Postgres ready on my laptop. With my databases now ready, I want to switch to the application. What if we built a real-time web app to help fight the COVID-19 pandemic? For its data, we can use the official COVID-19 dataset made publicly available by the UK government under the Open Government License. In the second part of the demo, I want to show you three superpowers that Postgres and Hyperscale Citus gives you for your app. First, let's use the PSQL Postgres client to connect to the basic tier database I created earlier. And let's take a peek into the data model. Here, I have a time series table, which captures metrics across different areas released at different timelines. The table has two partitions. The first partition holds a subset of the data from January to March of 2021, and the second holds another subset of data that's more recent, from April to June. I have about 100 million rows in the time series table, and the table is around 24 gigs in size. Now, as my data grows, can I archive and compress my older data? With Hyperscale Citus, doing that is now as simple as using columnar as the table access method for the first partition. It'll take several minutes to complete this operation. Let's fast forward. And now check the size of the table. 24 gigs fell to 4.2. Just by running a single command, I was able to compress my data by 5x. And depending on the shape of your data, you might see compression ratios of up to 10x. The next superpower is how easy it really is to scale my database. Here, I'll use the portal and add 4 Postgres nodes to my Hyperscale Citus deployment, each with 4 vCores and 32 gigs of RAM. Once the nodes are added, and after kicking off a simple command that rebalances the data, you'll see here that the data is being shuffled across the new nodes. What's really cool is that during the entire rebalance operation, your application does not take any downtime, not for your reads and not for your writes. In fact, you can scale your data layer from 2 vCores up to thousands of CPU cores and to terabytes of memory without causing any application downtime. For the third superpower, let's look at performance. Here, I divided my screen into two. On the left is the original basic tier deployment using one node, and on the right is my standard tier deployment with 4 worker nodes. I'll run this query, which gets me the total number of first dose vaccinations conducted across various nations in the UK. On the basic tier, the query finishes in around 3.1 seconds, scanning and filtering 100 million rows. I'll run the same query on the 4-node cluster, and voila, it completes in just around 800 milliseconds. Scaling my database horizontally with Hyperscale Citus gave me near linear scalability, 4x the nodes, 4x faster queries. To complete the workload, I'll also run here a short transactional query that updates an array attribute. As I expect from my operational database, it completes in just a matter of milliseconds. To recap, we covered three superpowers that Hyperscale Citus enables for your application. We reduced data volumes by more than 5x using the new columnar compression feature. We added 4 more Postgres nodes just by dragging a slider without incurring any downtime, and we speeded up queries by 4x. Now, what's really great is that the cloud-native application I've been talking about in this demo already exists in the real world. Here's the official UK government website for data and insights on COVID-19. It's a mission-critical app used to fight the pandemic, and it handles 100,000 concurrent users at peak times, and a user table holding 2.5 billion rows of time series data. The query we ran earlier in the demo actually corresponds to this chart on top right-hand side that shows how many citizens have received the first and second dose vaccines. You can click on it to drill down further. The application is very snappy, with Hyperscale Citus ensuring 95% of queries are running in under 0.4 seconds. I also want to call out that the data and source code are all open source. Here's the glimpse of the parent GitHub repo of the application. Like many other modern web apps, this app is built with open source software and public data, and runs on Azure Database for Postgres and Hyperscale Citus. We're proud to help fight this pandemic and support the hard work and dedication of the NHS teams in the UK.